Sometimes these internet companies always, they're so stupid. Who do they think we are? Stupid people. Yes, they do. Anyway, I don't like passing out my cell phone number. And I log in today and I have an account with Yahoo. Actually, my YouTube account links up with my Yahoo email address. And I log in today and they say, just to make sure that if you ever forget your password, that we'll have, da-da-da-da-da-da. Please give us your email address. No, sorry. Please give us your mobile address, your mobile number, so that we can send you the, No. So I got around it. If you do that again, I'll do the same thing again. I mean, and if you do that again, I'll pitch you. I have other ways. That is just like way too annoying. Don't even try to do that. If I give you my mobile number, that's one thing. But don't ask for it. Okay, I don't give you my mobile number. Of course, it's posted all over the place, but that doesn't mean you can use it. Okay, I'm being stupid, but whatever. Don't ask for it. I woke up around 5:15 and tossed and turned and didn't get back to sleep. I tried. It was too hot. I wasn't, whatever. I couldn't get back to sleep. At least I don't think I did. Maybe I did. And maybe I just thought I'd stopped, tossed and turned. Me and dreams are never on a good. I don't like dreaming. And even though my dreams lately have been fairly mild, I'm always uneasy when it comes to dreams. And I don't know if I, for that, hour and a quarter, if I just dreamt I was tossing and turning and went to sleep, or if I really did toss and turn. I thought about all sorts of things. So I wasn't really tossing and turning. I was trying to sleep and thinking of uneasy things. Which, when I'm awake, I don't think about. Don't like dreaming. Some people like dreaming. Most people I talk to don't mind dreaming, but I just don't like dreaming. They're always find they're uncomfortable. These last few ones that I remember have been fairly mild. Actually, just walking around type dreams, being places. But before that, I have years and years of uncomfortable situations. Being at work and not liking the people, or being uncomfortable with the situation, or just, not nice. I don't like it. I don't like it. I should put a dream catcher in my room. We did it with my son when he was a kid, little guy, before he became a really, really big guy. He was having bad dreams. And I thought, you know, I said to him, "Do you think if we put a dream catcher at your window, do you think you'll be okay?" And he said, "Oh, okay." I said, "Yeah, it'll probably." Well, I didn't ask him. I told him, I said, "This dream catcher will catch the bad dreams, and it'll only let the good dreams come true." So we hung one, and his dreams, bad dreams, went away. Think maybe I'll do that. Maybe I'll do that. See, yeah, you know, none of these things, I don't believe in anything, okay? But the mind is an idiot. Maybe I'll get a dream catcher to catch my bad dreams. You know what? If I do it, I will tell you guys about it and see if it works. Because you can, I know, even with this, even though I know it's just a bloody piece of metal, and it doesn't even have any religious significance, I can calm myself down like nothing. So, the mind can be tricked, even though it knows it's being tricked. I love my mind.